Hello and welcome to this lesson. This lesson I'm going to cover AWS Copilot. Now it will be a hands-on lesson, so I'm going to give you a brief introduction to Copilot and then we're going to go in and actually see it in action. And that's the best way to understand what Copilot can do for you. So Copilot is a command line interface for launching and managing containers. So as you'll see shortly, it's going to be a way that we can, with a few simple commands, create a containerized application. And of course, it uses deployment pipelines if you want it to. It can use a well-architected infrastructure setup process as well. And it can deploy your containerized infrastructure using ECS, using Fargate, or using App Runner. So those are the three services which it integrates with in terms of running your containerized application. It's based on infrastructure as code templates. So it's actually going to build out those templates for you. You run some simple commands to build out your containerized environment. And here's an example of a few of those commands. Simple commands like Copilot init to initialize and build your Copilot environment. Then you can look at your applications and show information about your environments, listing the services and so on. Now we'll see a few of these in action, in a hands-on. We're going to build a simple demo containerized environment. So in the course download, you should find this document. It's within the AWS Copilot directory. It's called copilotcommands.md. Now, the first command we're going to run is to launch an EC2 instance. So we can run this command AWS EC2 run instances and specify an image ID. Now, you need to make sure that you've got a current image ID. Easy way to do that is in EC2, choose your region that you're going to perform this exercise in. I recommend US East 1. Click on launch instances. And then let's just copy the AMI ID here. And this is associated with the Amazon Linux 2 AMI. And this is a current ID. So when you get to this lab, almost undoubtedly the ID will have changed because they change very regularly. So I'm going to come back and paste that in, make sure I've got a space for my next part of the command. So now I've got the image ID and it's going to be a T2 micro. So I can copy this whole command and I'm going to run this on Cloud Shell. In the Cloud Shell console, let's just run this command and that should launch our EC2 instance. And that has. So let's now go into EC2. I just want to check the security group. I didn't specify a security group, so it's going to put it into the default one. So under security, I'm going to choose security groups and I just need to make sure I've got an inbound rule for port 22 from anywhere. And I don't in this case. So let's click on edit inbound rules. Let's add one. I need SSH. From anywhere, and that's going to allow us to use EC2 Instance Connect. So now let's go back to instances. Our instance is launching, and we should be able to connect over EC2 Instance Connect. Great, so we are on the console, and of course, it's telling us we should run sudo yum update. So let's just go ahead and do that. Click on yes, and there it goes. And let's now go over and have a look at the next commands we need to run. So the next thing we need to do is we need to install and configure Docker. Okay, so there's a few commands here that need to be run in sequence in order to be able to install and configure Docker to be ready for use. After that, we're going to install Git, then the Copilot CLI, then we're going to clone a repository, then we're going to run the initialization command to start the build. And that's going to build out our environment. All right, so let's get started. The next command is to install Docker. So I'm just going to run each of these commands one by one, starting with installing Docker. And you might have to type Y and press Enter for some of these commands. Next one is to enable the Docker service and then start the Docker service. So let's run that command, created a symlink. Next one, get the service started. No errors, so everything looks good. Let me just clear the screen so you can see everything more easily. Then we need to modify some permissions. Let's paste this command in and run these final two commands. All related to permissions, paste that one in, and that's Docker installed and ready for use. The next thing to do is simply install Git because we're going to clone a repository. So that's just simply sudo yum install git, Y and enter, and that's going to be installed. Excellent, that's done. Next, we're going to install the Copilot CLI. So this is the full command on line 15 from where it says sudo right through to where it says help. This is going to clone the CLI to a local directory on the EC2 instance. So again, I'll clear my screen so you can see me run this command. And there we go, that's done. The next thing we need to do is install the Copilot CLI. For that, we just run this entire command from line 15. Let's run that command. and that has completed successfully. Next, we need to clone the Copilot repository and then change into the app directory. So we're cloning from a GitHub repository. It's the Amazon ECS CLI sample app.git, and we're going to create our application called demo app. And for that, we need a directory. So let's clone this repository. I'll clear the screen again. Let's clone the repository. Very quickly, that has been done. And then we just change to the demo app directory. So back in here, let's change in and let's have a look at what's in here. So we can see there's a couple of MD files, there's a Docker file, there's an index.html, a license and a README. If you want to have a look at the Docker file, of course, you can just read it from here. It simply says from Nginx, copy index.html to this location. The next thing we need to do is run the init command to start the build. So this is going to be where we actually use Copilot. So now we run the Copilot init command with the app called demo. The name is API. It's a load balanced web service. It uses a Docker file, which is the Docker file in the current directory. And the port is 80 because it's a web service and we're going to deploy. Now, of course, Copilot is going to need some permissions. So there's a couple of things we have to do before we can run this command. I'm in the Identity and Access Management service and I'm going to create a role. And this is the role that's going to be used by the service to create the resources. And of course, we're using EC2. So EC2 needs to be able to assume the role so that it has the permissions to perform the actions via Copilot. So the use case is EC2. Now, what permissions do we need? Well, there's quite a few permissions here. We're going to have some ECS permissions and some load balancing permissions. So you may be able to restrict and create a policy that gives you exactly what you need for this particular exercise. Obviously not a best practice, but I'm just going to use administrator access to make sure it works. Of course, in a real world scenario, outside of a demo, you'll want to make sure you lock down the specific permissions you need. So for the role name, I'm simply going to call this one admin access because that's what the role provides and create that role. The role has been created. So let's go to EC2. We need to attach the role. I'm going to use actions security modify IAM role and give it the admin access role. Another thing we need to do is back on our instance, let's just run AWS configure. Not because we need to supply any access keys, but because I want to provide the default region name, US East 1. That's the region I am using, North Virginia, which is US East 1. So press enter and enter again. That's the only variable I needed to supply there. All right, so I've got that. Now I should be able to run my Copilot command. So back in the file here, let's copy the entire command from line 6, come back, paste that into my EC2 Instance Connect terminal, and off we go. So you're going to see quite a lot happening as we go through this process. You can see a lot of feedback in the console telling you what's being created. For instance, IAM roles, we've got ECR repositories and KMS keys and S3 buckets. So there can be a small cost to this lab. Just make sure that when you run this command, you are aware that it's going to do a few things. KMS keys, for example, cost about $1 each. So make sure that you're aware of that before you actually hit that enter command and run this particular setup. And of course, as long as you destroy this environment at the end, it's not going to cost you much at all, if anything, because we're not going to be using it for very long. Now we can see that CloudFormation is being used in the console feedback here. So let's go over to CloudFormation and see what is actually going on in CloudFormation. So in CloudFormation, firstly, we can see the demo infrastructure roles has been created. So that's something that's just happened. And if we go into that particular stack, go to events, we can see what's being created. And in this case, that's simply the execution roles and administrator roles and so on that were created in IAM. If you go to outputs, we've got the administrator role ARN, which is of course in IAM, and the execution role ARN, which again is an IAM role. The whole setup can take several minutes, so you'll be able to sit back and watch what's going on. Keep an eye in CloudFormation for additional resources being created. And in a few minutes time, this should complete successfully. All right, so that took a little while. Of course, it takes 10, 15 minutes, something like that, to build out your environment. And as you can see, just by scrolling back through what's happened, there's been a lot. There's lots of different resources created. So this is that well-architected, best practice, secure configuration for your containerized application. And we'll have a look at some of the components that have been out. But first, it says here you can access your service at, and then it gives me this URL. So if I just put this into my browser, and there we go, there's my app. So nothing too exciting, but it is working. Now let's have a look at the components. Of course, if you come back into CloudFormation here, I think this is all of it, you can see that there's been a few different stacks created. We've got the infrastructure roles here, we've got the demo infrastructure, demo test, and test API. So you can always have a look through these and then have a look at what resources are being created. So you're going to find lots of different resources. Some of those resources include multiple Lambda functions. We've of course got an ECS cluster with one running task. We have a demo API and an image here. This is Elastic Container Registry. So this is the container image that was used. In S3 here, we can see we have an S3 bucket with some assets there. It's created a Copilot demo test VPC with subnets, internet gateway, and so on. It's also created a private hosted zone called test.demo.local for private DNS resolution within this environment. So lots of different components, and all we did was run one simple command. So as you can see, it's very, very powerful. Now there's a few Copilot commands that you can run to check the status of your application, like Copilot app ls. That just tells us that we have this application. You can run Copilot app show, and that gives you a little bit more information about the environment. So that's it for the demo of Copilot, a very simple way to build containerized environments. In fact, once you've set up Docker and you've got your environment configured correctly, you can run one single Copilot command to build out all of this infrastructure. So very powerful indeed. We do want to make sure that we remove our resources, and there's one simple way of doing that. So just as it's easy to build, it's easy to destroy as well. So we can run Copilot app delete, and that should remove all of the resources. So back on EC2 Instance Connect, I'm simply going to run Copilot app delete, type Y, press enter, and yes, it's going ahead and it's going to remove all of those resources. So I would keep an eye on CloudFormation. It should delete all of those stacks. Make sure it does delete everything correctly. Make sure it has removed all the resources so you don't end up paying for anything that you don't need.